Have you ever made the decision to wake up early only to fail miserably? Or maybe you did it for 1 to 3 days and then you just felt like crap the entire day. Like by the end of the day, you were completely exhausted. It's like a bag of bricks hit you all day long. I know how you feel. I felt the same way too. And after conquering this area of my life, I was able to start waking up early and be massively productive. My name's Joe Moffitt with Master Life by Design, and today I'm gonna teach you how to wake up easily and be massively productive for your day. See, the truth is, no one really wants to wake up early. We're just told to wake up early because, well, that's what successful people do, right? If you watch and look and study at successful people, you see they usually wake up. There's a great book, I'll put it in the comments below, called The 5 a.m. Club, where a lot of people are like, all right, I'm gonna get up at 5 a.m. And you know, maybe around New Year's Eve, people make the decision, I'm gonna wake up early. And I can't tell you how many clients I've coached over the years that say, I'm gonna wake up early, I'm gonna make it happen, I'm gonna make this a lifestyle, a habit, so I can be massively productive for my day and get ahead. And while that's great, I hear it a lot, but what I see most of the time is people fail miserably. Now, why? Why do they fail miserably? The reason they fail miserably is because they have no idea, other than successful people do it, that they should wake up early, and they're too tired, right? They just wake up and they're just like exhausted. With that being said, let me give you my number one strategy on how I went from waking up at like 6:45, 7 range, all the way up to 3:59 in the morning, right? And you might sit there and be like, oh my God, Joe, like I could never do that. Don't worry, we're gonna talk about that statement here in a moment. But my number one strategy is this. When I first started, I tried, right? I tried to get up at 5 a.m. and I failed miserably. I woke up, I was like, I'm way too tired, went back to sleep. I was like, all right, I'm gonna join, you know, 4 o'clock like other people were doing because, you know what, hey, I heard everyone was doing it, why not try it? All of a sudden, what I found was I was doing way more harm than good. Because if you make a decision like, oh, I'm gonna get up at 5 a.m. and you don't, you start proving to your brain and pulling these references. Remember last time you tried and you didn't do it? And you have these references that your brain constantly reminds you of why you can't. And so what you wanna do is you wanna be able to trick your brain. So how do you trick your brain? So what you're gonna wanna do is figure out what is the normal time that you wake up. So let's just say it's 6:45. That used to be where I would wake up. From there, I would go ahead and I would wake up 5 minutes earlier at 6:40. And then I give it about 3 to 4, maybe 5 days to let my body acclimate and get used to it. And then I would go to 6:35 and 6:30. And then I'd work my way all the way down to 5 a.m., hit that 5 a.m. club, which again is a great book. I'll post it in the comments below. And then all of a sudden I would wake up at 4:40 to go to the gym. And sometimes my body even wakes me up at, what was it, 3:59, right? And so you wanna make sure that you're actually using an app, by the way, that I love, and it's called Sleep Cycle. And it helps me with my alarm because it's not like a traditional alarm where it goes, right? It's like you wake up to a gradual, peaceful alarm. And so you don't put your body in fight or flight right out of the gate. Right, because if you're in fight or flight, you're gonna actually stack on top of all the reasons why you don't wanna get up early. So what you wanna do, find out what time do you usually wake up, get a baseline for it, and then work 5 minutes earlier, because you're tricking your brain, right? You're telling your brain, well, 5 minutes, that's not a big deal, and you're giving yourself 3 to 5 days for your body to acclimate, and all of a sudden, you're feeling excited. You're gonna find yourself waking up a lot easier as time goes on. Now, this may take a couple weeks, and that's okay. We gotta figure out where you're at, and so know thyself. That's my number one rule in coaching, know thyself, know where you start, know where you're at. Now, the second strategy, well, I'll say this, this is more of the psychology component, this second strategy, because look, everything is 20% strategy, 80% psychology, so we wanna work on the 80%. So the second component, or the second strategy here is, you gotta shift your focus and your stories. You have to shift your focus in your stories, right? Because you tell yourself certain things when you wake up. Oh, I'm tired, it's comfy, I'm warm, I don't feel like getting out of bed. You know, just give me 5 more minutes. Have any of you ever said that? Because I certainly have, and I know a lot of my clients have too, right? But what happens is we focus on what we don't want to do versus how we're going to feel once we're up and we're productive, right? Like you think about, oh, the warm bed's warm versus I'm going to feel amazing, alive and alert for today when I'm done working out at the gym. Or I'm going to feel amazing when my wife comes downstairs and gives me a big hug and kiss because I wrote her a love letter and put it on her computer, right? Or you focus on how much energy you're going to have throughout the day instead of 5 more minutes, because we all know that when you actually wake up and then you take time like 10, 15, 20 more minutes, you actually feel more tired than if you would have got up originally. So you have to work on, what do you focus on? What do you tell yourself when you wake up? And one thing I explore with my clients, and I did this with myself, is we have them write down all their current limiting stories, and I encourage you to do the same. And then I ask them, who's your role model? And you write down your role model, the ones that do get up early, that are, have the success that you want in your life. And it's not just financial, it could be, you know, relationally or, you know, your career, whatever it is. And you write that role model down. And then I ask them this question, what do you think they tell themselves when they get up? And I know you don't know, but if you have the ability to ask them, ask them. But even if you don't, if it's someone like, you know, I don't know, Gary Vaynerchuk or someone like that, what could you imagine they tell themselves, right? Based on what you know about them, what would they tell themselves? And write that down, because that's something you want to do also. So you got to shift your focus and watch the story that you tell yourself, that little voice in your head that we all have, okay? So it holds us back big time. The next component, number three, is you got to have a psychology shift in your identity, right? You got to shift your identity. Because most people, they say, I'm a night owl. Yes, you got it. All right. They say, oh, I'm a night owl. I can never be an early riser. I can never wake up that early. I'm not a morning person, right? We hear all these excuses. So you gotta shift how you see yourself. If you see yourself as a night owl, you gotta change that to, hey, I'm an early riser. Right? You gotta make that shift, because if you don't, what's gonna happen is you're gonna wanna be consistent with your identity of the night owl, and you'll self-sabotage your pattern. And so what we wanna make sure is, if you are gonna become this early riser, you're gonna adopt this strategy, you're gonna work on your stories, you also gotta be smart, because you gotta be able to make sure that you get enough sleep, right? I know my sweet spot is about 7.5 hours, okay? Now, I can do up to about 6 hours on the lower end. 5 hours and 45 minutes is like the edge for me, but I wanna make sure I get that 7.5 hours. Now, our body, we have sleep cycles. We sleep 90-minute cycles, so hour and a half, 3 hours, 4.5, 6, 7.5, 9, right? And so you got to know yourself, where's your cycle where you feel like, all right, I got enough sleep, so that you can start working back from there. And so if I'm going to wake up at let's just say 4:30 in the morning, and I'm saying I need 7.5 hours to feel great, well, then I got to back that up, right? So 7.5, what's that? 9:30, I got to be in bed. And so I typically find myself in bed between 9 and 10. So I can get that 7.5 hours. Now I wake up at 7:40 to go work out. Sometimes my body wakes me up at 3:59. It is what it is. You're gonna find that you'll know when you're an early morning riser is when your body is waking you up before your alarm. It would shock you, because your body's an amazing tool. It's so brilliant. So anyway, that's when you'll know that you are a morning riser, right? And lastly, the last strategy is you have to get clear on what you're going to do for today. And so when I work with my 6, 7, 8-figure entrepreneurs, one of the biggest things we look at is, what are your revenue producing activities for the day? And those activities are usually the most challenging and the most difficult, right? They probably take the longest amount of time usually too, right? Because as humans, we have this human nature, the path of least resistance. We want to do the easy stuff first, but usually the easy stuff isn't the most productive stuff. And so we get clear first thing in the morning so that you can just go ahead and execute. And once you do that, you're gonna be massively productive. You're gonna start to see your income go up, your body get better, your relationships get better, right? You're gonna see a whole slew of changes. Now, I'm no financial advisor. I'm just saying that when I started waking up early at like 5 a.m., I think it was 4:30 this last year, over the last 2 years as I've been doing that, I've had my best financial years year over year. And so I wonder if there's a correlation there at all. And my business has grown, right? And I've become a better father, a better husband. My body's in great shape, right? So there's some correlation there, because why? You get more time to be productive. And Arnold Schwarzenegger said it great. You sleep for 6 hours, you work the other 18 hours, right? And if you don't have enough time, you just sleep faster, and so that you can be more productive. I love that quote. And look, you might want to say, okay, I'm going to get up at 5 a.m. And again, I love the quote. It says, legends wake up or go to bed at 5 a.m. And so you got to make a decision. Are you joining the 5 a.m. club, 4:30, 4 a.m. club, whatever club you want to join? Make that decision. So write that down. I'm going to start getting up. I'm going to get up at, let's just say, 5:30 in the morning. Like, I'm going to start there at 5:30, which is awesome. And I applaud you for that. But make sure you know where you usually do, how much sleep you need to have, adjust your sleep schedule, but wake up 5 minutes earlier. Also go to bed 5 minutes earlier as you do this cycle, this strategy for you to be able to wake up easily in the morning and be able to be massively productive. I can't tell you how many clients that I have that are having so much success with these strategies that I shared with you today, and it's helped their business grow exponentially. It's helped their relationships grow exponentially, their bodies exponentially. So if you're really looking to take your body, your relationships, your finances to the next level, you gotta work on the things behind the scenes, like waking up earlier and being clear so that you can be massively productive for today. All right, guys, if you found value in this video today, please hit that thumbs up button, click the subscribe button. We're doing 3 videos a week for you in the areas of personal development, relationship, business, and finance. So I'm really excited about delivering more throughout the year for you guys. So hit that subscribe button. If you found that this is valuable and want to be able to pass it on to a friend, a loved one, a colleague, an employee, maybe the ones that are late, please pass this along so that they can get what they need to be able to wake up earlier and be way more productive in their day. So my name is Joe Moffitt with Master Life by Design. Looking forward to having you on the next video. See ya.